Welcome students, welcome to the second part of my video. In this video we will see how the French and the Portuguese, they gave our territory back to India so that, you know, we may fulfill the true independence. Now, as we have seen in the first part, there were 600 princely states, and we could see the initiative taken by Sardar Vallabhai Patel. He took the initiative and he convinced all the princely states to merge with India. We saw later on the three states which were not merged with India. Princely states, they were Hyderabad, Junagadh and Kashmir. Later on, these three states merged with India. Now, my dear students, now we will see how French colonies merged with India. As we all know, French ruled the regions like Chandranagar, Puducherry, Karaikal, Mahe, Yanam. The Indian natives, they were not at all interested to be with French. They were demanding that this territory should merge with India. Later on in 1949, France held a plebiscite. Plebiscite means an opinion, where they took the people's opinion whether what they want to do, whether they want to be with French, with France, or with India. And the people voted for India, and especially the territory of Chandranagar. You know, in 1949 they held a plebiscite where Chandranagar, they wanted to merge with India. So thereafter France handed over all the rest of the territories to the Indian government. Now we will see how the struggle of liberation of Goa. As we all know, Goa was under the rule of Portuguese, and Portuguese, they were not ready to give up these territory. So there was one gentleman called Dr. T.B. Kuna who took a lead role to bring about awakening among the people against the government, Portuguese government, with the objective of building struggle against Portuguese. He established Goa Congress Committee in 1945. Dr. Kuna founded an organization called Goa Youth League in Mumbai. In 1946, he went to Goa, violated a ban on public speech. For this, he was sentenced to 8 years imprisonment. In 1946, Dr. Ram Manohar Lohia started a satyagraha for liberation of Goa. Violating the ban, he delivered a public speech at Madgaon in Goa. For this, Portuguese government deported Ram Manohar Lohia. Now, during this period, Azad Gomantak Dal was founded to liberate Portuguese colonies of Dadar Nagar Haveli in Gujarat. On 2nd August 1954, youths of Azad Gomantak Dal, by making an armed attack, liberated the territories of Dadar Nagar Haveli from Portuguese rule. Vishwanath Lavande, Rajprabhu Vankar, Sudhir Phadke, Nanasaheb Kajrekar, they took a part in this attack. In 1954, Goa Mukti Samiti was formed, and the Samiti went on batches of satyagrahis from Maharashtra to Goa. N.G. Gore, Senapati Bapat, Peter Alvarez, Mahadev Shastri Joshi, his wife Sudhatai, and many others participated in the satyagraha. Mohan Ranade was an aggressive leader in the struggle for the liberation of Goa. The Portuguese rulers committed unlimited tyranny and atrocities on satyagrahis. due to this public opinion became more infuriated. The struggle for liberation of Goa took up a furious form. The Indian government was patiently holding negotiation with the Portuguese government, but they did not respond. At the end, Indian government unwillingly took a decision of using force, especially military force. In December 1961, Indian army entered Goa. In short period of time, Portuguese army surrendered. On 19th September, on 19th December 1961, Goa was liberated from Portuguese dominance. Imperialism was completely rooted out from Indian soil, and Indians' freedom struggle was truly fulfilled. Thus, I would like to conclude my lesson by saying that by liberating Dadar Nagar Haveli, Puducherry, Pondicherry, Goa, we could see truly India got liberated from the foreign yoke, and the true taste of independence was witnessed by the Indians. Thank you, my dear students, for their patient hearing. I request you, if you like the video, please like it. If you have not subscribed the video, please subscribe it. And also, share it with others, especially those people, those who are not having their online sessions. Please share this video with them so that they may get the knowledge. Thank you, my dear students.